Hello everyone, I'm finally back to Antrip Zoo. For those who are new to the channel, welcome, my name is Sip, and I have made it my personal mission to recreate the Antrip Zoo located in Belgium in Planet Zoo. I've been busy over the past few weeks. If you follow the mod scene, you'd have noticed a lot of dinosaur mods being uploaded to Nexus Mods. So yeah, that was me. But I am taking a little break from porting over JWE dinosaurs to spend some precious time in my favorite zoo. Of course, we also got awesome news about next week's DLC, the Europe pack. I am so excited for it. So excited, in fact, that I even forgot to properly edit my trailer breakdown video. My apologies for the little outtake there at the beginning. But yeah, consider me very excited for all the new props that we are going to get. I was pretty much spot on with my prediction 2 months ago. I think I got the lynx, the badger, the ibex, and the fire salamander all correct. And I even predicted the whole fairy tale theme. But I could never have imagined all the cool stuff that would come along with it. We are getting food trucks. And it turns out the marquee props are probably going to be these nice little Christmas stands from the trailer. I just can't wait to use all these new pieces in this zoo. But anyways, let's talk a bit about the actual thing I'm building right here. So in the last episode I built Hippotopia, which is basically the hippo building and habitat. But it is part of a larger swamp biome Antrip Zoo wants to simulate. The aviary I'm building right here is located to the northern side of Hippotopia and includes various bird species such as vulturine guinea fowl, black-crowned crane, marabou, Ruppel's vulture, and two species of duck. The swamp biome was designed by Patrick de Sterk and Gudrun de Waale, and originally the aviary was a walkthrough habitat where you could go from one end to the other. This has been changed, however, and currently you can still enter the aviary, but you are kind of limited to a little hut. So this is my first big aviary build in the zoo. I think I had, of course, the parrot or the macaw aviary in another area of the zoo, but yeah, this is the first big aviary that I'm building, not just in this zoo, but just in Planet Zoo in general. And that makes me wonder, like, are we ever gonna get the aviary DLC? It's on everyone's wish list. A lot of people wanted the next DLC to be an aviary pack, but of course I knew we wouldn't get that for Christmas because there was just no indication of birds or flying animations being added in the code. Everything kind of hinted towards some kind of coastal slash European theme, which in the end we of course got with a very Venice-inspired theme. But yeah, I am still hoping for an aviary pack. Hopefully it'll be like the first DLC we will get in 2022. But there's, like, at this moment, and the data mine leaks have been pretty consistent with predicting DLCs, there's like no indication at all about birds being added to Planet Zoo right now. But yeah, this giant green steel aviary took me some time to make. Of course, everything in here is sped up to look a bit quicker and a bit more digestible in a YouTube video. But it took me some time, as evidenced by the fact that it took me, like, how long has it been since my last Antrip Zoo video? Like, more than a month or something? More than 2 months, maybe even? Of course, I have been busy with other stuff, such as the Euro pack, or the European Midnight mod pack that I made. The dinosaurs I'm porting over. Just, like, releases of new games like JWE2. Like, there's generally a lot of, like, other content creators are probably a bit, or might relate to this, that they're putting Planet Zoo a bit more on the back burner. But nonetheless, I am still very committed to this zoo and still very committed to making the entirety of the Antwerp Zoo a reality in this game. So I'm happy, really happy, in fact, that Planet Zoo added all these mesh pieces, because without them, this build would literally have been impossible to make. I don't even know which pieces I would have used, probably like something like rope or something, but that would amount to a huge amount of pieces in this group here. Yeah, a lot of little details here and there wouldn't have been possible without these mesh pieces. Like, everything is there for an aviary pack in my opinion. Like, we do have mesh pieces, we do have enough of them to make cool looking aviaries, like this one in fact. I think the only thing that we're missing besides the animals is maybe some kind of mechanic that'll, like, a dynamic aviary roof, I would say. Like, imagine you build a habitat, you use, like, you put down all the barriers, and then you have an option to click to basically add a roof to it, like add a mesh roof. That would be my ideal way of doing aviaries that aren't like some specific design like this one. And then it would be awesome if you could add like poles in the middle of the aviary, and they like pull up the meshes, like the poles I have in the Savannah aviary. But yeah, I'm of course using again this spiral staircase from the Steam Workshop, because I do not want to spend an hour or more on doing a spiral staircase. I of course redid some things here and there to make it a bit more looking like the style that I want to go for this build here. But yeah, of course that spiral staircase there leads into this this little viewing area on top of the Hippotopia building. And I think I went over it in the last episode, but you can actually go from there and have a nice little panoramic view of the hippo habitat. Yeah, so that's what I'm building over here. There is quite some things that I didn't record in this speed build. For example, I don't think I recorded me building that little area up top there. I don't think I recorded the little hut, like the octagonal hut that is down below. I don't even remember if I recorded me doing the foliage for this habitat. But yeah, there's a lot of stuff I left out or I kind of forgot about. Because you know how it happens, like you're doing something, you're building something in Planet Zoo, you're kind of so focused on it that you forget to do all these other stuff. Of course, the reverse can also be true, that you are like going from one place to another in your habitat, that you're so sidetracked by something you found online or something. Like, while I was writing this script for the intro there about the history and stuff of this habitat, I was so sidetracked. I took like 5 minutes to write the first sentence or something. Yeah, even though it's like not really that much effort to find the information and stuff. But yeah, it took me quite a long time to actually write the script. So yeah, that's another thing I don't think I've said before in a video, that I do write like scripts for the like little history parts of the speed build. So yeah, I actually do that. I actually take the time to do research, to look into old maps, to look into old photographs of all these little habitats here and there in the zoo, and like the history that they went through and stuff like that. So yeah, history is one of my passions, if you can't tell. The other one being animals, just wildlife in general. Like, not even just animals. Like, if you saw all my dinosaur mods, of course dinosaurs are a big passion too. And recently I've picked up Pokemon again. I actually bought the what is it, the Shining Pearl for the Nintendo Switch. So yeah, I've been playing a bit of that as well. But yeah, I enjoy it. All these little passion projects and stuff like that. Yeah. So I did actually record me adding in foliage and dead trees and stuff. Okay, so that's good. God, I remember looking for the exact kind of tree I needed there. I remember that. I do hope we are getting some more, like, or better trees in the Europack. Because we, like, I don't know what it is, but all the trees that we have are kind of like, their leaves really start low. I kind of want, like, trees that have their leaves only start, like, really high up. But I don't know. I don't know. I'm just hoping for a lot of foliage in the next pack. A lot of European foliage it will be, probably. But yeah. So yeah, this little area up top here is usually where you can see marabous and the vultures hang out. I don't think the ground cranes come up there often. When I went, there was literally only marabous on the top there. And then I think the vultures were on the... close to the nest of the, or one of the nests of the marabou, I think. But, oh yeah, that's something I forgot to tell, or I should probably tell. But I think, yeah, Antwerp Zoo recently had, like, and by recently I mean like, probably almost like half a year ago or something. They had marabou chicks for the first time in Belgium, so that's exciting. So I think two of them. I'm not too sure if they are male or female. I think they are two females. But yeah, that's exciting news. So actually the first time in Belgium that marabous reproduce and get offspring in captivity. So yeah, really exciting. But I see that we're getting to the end of the speed build here. And I am very excited to show this entire habitat in the actual game. Because there's a lot of stuff that didn't make the cut. So, see you there. And we're in the live part of the game. So, I'm actually looking at the hippos right now, with the rhinos in the back there. Because, unfortunately, the hippos, like both hippos in Antwerp Zoo, have contracted COVID. It's actually the first case, or the first known case, of hippos contracting the disease. So I'm a bit anxious to see what will happen to them. I'm not too sure like if they're really sick or not, if they're showing symptoms or anything. But yeah, I'm a bit worried about this happening to other animals that may be more vulnerable. I know big cats are like really vulnerable to COVID, but yeah. So if you go to the zoo, please do not sneeze on the hippos. In return, they will not sneeze on you as well. I cannot guarantee that, but yeah, if we go down here, you can actually go into the aviary here, or a little like viewing area. So this is this viewing area. I think it's a bit too tall. I built it a bit too tall. Like, I feel really small right now compared to what it actually should be. But yeah, so in here, you, if the sun is not like staring you right in the face, actually I can change it now, but yeah, normally the sun wouldn't be there, of course. Something I've noticed, by the way, is like right now I have my time. Let me actually. Okay, let's set it like around here. Actually, I want to make a point. I want to show you where the sun is at noon. So the sun is supposed to be at its highest point at noon, right? That's basic science. No matter where you are in the world, the sun will always be at its highest point at noon. At least I think that's how it works. So what happens? Oh, the sun is going up. It's higher now? Huh. That's weird. How late is it? Almost 3. Well, that's not right. Anyways. That's a bit of an issue, I think. I discovered that the time scale on Planet Zoo is not accurate. Not completely accurate. Anyways, doesn't really matter. I just want to show you this aviary. But yeah, let's actually go through here. So we have this top level here, with on the, sorry,
on the left side, like little boxes, where the birds can go in, I guess. The marabous. I haven't actually seen any of the birds go in there. But yeah, there's this little top section here, where the flying birds, I guess, can go. Over there we have a little. That's, I think their nest was over there, where they had the eggs and stuff. Okay, the zookeeper is there. Okay, good. Yeah, a little sneak peek here. So I built this, there's this little hut. This is where you can actually view the aviary from inside. And it's octagonal shaped. And my god, this was a hell to build. This was the literal hell on earth. Luckily, I was watching the Planet Zoo live stream at that point when I was building this. So that kind of gave me some comfort, some cozy feelings. Especially the fairy tale that was told. That was so good. I think it was Francesca who wrote that. That was really good. That was a really nice way to give a little like sneak peek of what we were gonna get. But yeah. This is the little like area up top. You can look at all the birds that it's like that meme from Fairly Odd Parents. This is where I put my birds if I had any. But yeah, this is literally where I would have put my birds if I had any. Of course, if you can see some birds down there. Those are the Vulturine guinea fowls. It's a mod made by Leaf Productions, if you know him only by his YouTube name. But yeah, very cool that we can actually have birds in here. I think Jen is or was working on some crane mods, like crown crane, gray crown crane and stuff like that. She hasn't been working on mods, I think, for a while now. I do hope she comes back and finishes all of her amazing work in progress stuff. But yeah, so I also tilted all of these wooden like planks. Okay, I went through the effort of tilting them so you had this like look. Oh crap, I fell. Well, you can see it from down here as well, like they are all tilted. Let me quickly go up the spiral staircase again. But yeah, so you would usually go then back down here. So I went up to make the point that you go back down here. So you go back down here, and at this point this is netted over because we are now in the aviary. Yeah, so that's quite cool. You can actually go in here, have a closer look at the birds. They are really small. When I went, they were over there. Like, they were eating, I guess. I think. Why? Okay, this is confusing. So there's a literal food bowl right here. Why did the zookeeper put all the food over here? Like, there's literally a food bowl right here. Okay. Enough hating on this game. But it's awesome. I'm so excited for the next DLC. Yeah. So that's the Vulturine guinea fowl over here. And then of course I had to change up this a bit. Because, well, I discovered that this hallway, this little hallway here, was a bit longer than I had it originally. But yeah, you would then come through here. Into the hippo building, where the hippos are gonna sneeze on you, or you are gonna sneeze on the hippos and give them COVID. But yeah, so looks like we have some people here looking at. I must say, these people are not smart. These people are smart. See, these people know where to get the bad quality images of. I didn't know they did that. Like, took out a phone to take pictures. But yeah, this is where the good viewing area is. Okay. That being said though, like, I don't know if there's anything else to show off here. Can just show off. I'm so proud of this rock work. Like, with the little drin grass, which is now my favorite plant in the entire game. Like, I'm so happy. But yeah. So what's next for Antwerp Zoo? As you can see here, this is not finished at all, this whole area. And that's because of the next project in Antwerp Zoo are more aviaries, surprisingly. It's the aviaries that line this path here, this path that eventually branches off and goes here. So that will be my project for the next episode. The aviary building, or the aviaries that are attached to this big one right over here. So I hope you enjoyed this little video. I think it's gonna be a bit shorter than usual. Nonetheless, I'm so excited to also show you what I have in store with the European or the Europe DLC coming up. I actually have quite a cool ID that I want to do that will be perfect for what's going to come our way in a few weeks. That being said, I hope you enjoyed this, and I hope you enjoyed all the recent news concerning Planet Zoo, and I hope to see you in a next video. Goodbye!